angry guy here. Foreign women anger homeless single mothers. Foreign women anger homeless single mothers. Let's just go ahead and jump right into the video.
Hi everybody, I hope you are doing well and thank you so much for being here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's get right into it. Today I would like to critique a video which shows a single mother parent who brought her son, obviously, to her first date. Now, first of all, before I start talking about the video, I would like to say that I am not here judging anybody for being a single parent. Matter of fact, I have highly respect for anyone who is raising a child all by themselves. I know being a single parent comes with a lot of challenges, with a lot of sleepless nights where you probably think about a lot of stuff, but at the end of the day, I feel as though that the child is the one who is suffering the most, especially when there is trouble going on between mother and father. I personally think that a mother will never be able to replace a father's energy, and a father will never be able to replace a mother's energy. I hope they'll see
it through. So she said something really important. I know you guys want to watch the video. If I don't jump in, then I'm going to forget. She said that a father can never replace a mother's energy, and a mother can never replace a father's energy. Do you guys ever notice how women are constantly trying to replace the fathers, saying that they're the fathers? On Father's Day, they're sitting around expecting cards and gifts. On Father's Day, they have Mother's Day. And here's the crazy thing about Father's Day. Most fathers don't even want Father's Day anymore, okay? Because what does dad get? Dad at best gets a pair of socks and a tie because he needs to know to go to work. Like, basically, those are Father's Day gifts. You know, gifts for him when he goes to work because that's what his purpose is. These women are literally pushing this dialogue. If you notice, men never say that they can replace a mother. They never try to do that. They never say, well, you know what? It's Mother's Day, but I'm a single father and I need to have my crown, you know? No, they leave women with their space. They constantly acknowledge that, you know, a man cannot replace a mother. But women constantly emphasize that they don't need no man and that they were the mother and father that their children needed. And that's because they are so deep in their masculine and they will never learn their lessons in Western society. But let's just go ahead and continue watching.
So I have seen this clip on Instagram, and of course I scroll through the comments, obviously we all do, and there's this one female, I think she's a celebrity, she has a blue check mark next to her name is Portia for real, and said, this is beautiful to me, this is what you could have if you would act right. Here's my take on it. First of all, when we make certain decisions, we're gonna have to deal with the consequences, whether if we like it or not. And in this case, with that comment especially, I don't agree with it, because you cannot say that a man is missing something because he's not acting right. Because if mother and father, in this case, both parties would have acted right, this mother would not even be on a date with a child looking for another man, okay? The child would not have to grow up with several men in his life. I don't know if this female does this all the time, like every time she goes on a date, she brings her son. What does it mean for the child? You cannot expose a child to different men that you are on a date with every time you go on a date. And that is why you, especially as a female, can't run around and trying to do whatever men are doing. It's not going to work, because every time you sleep with a man, there is a high risk or possibility that you may end up being pregnant. And I'm sorry I have to say this, and the great Kevin Samuels used to stress this all the time and make females understand, when you are a single mother, your sexual marketplace value is going down. It's decreasing. And yes, it is a fact, because I remember him saying, are women willing to share a man? And most of the time, women are going to be like, no, if that's his, my man, that's going to be my man. Okay, but why does a man have to share his time with another man's child? A man doesn't have to raise another man's child. And I completely agree with it. Now, it's not the child's fault here, you know. Every child deserves a beautiful, loving mother, father household. And again, we also know being a single mother comes with a lot of challenges, responsibilities. It is a 24/7 job. So also, a lot of women are looking for men who will not just only support them, but also take over some of the responsibilities that comes with having a child. But why would a man want to do that? Why would a man want to end up with a woman, let's say she's in her mid, late 20s, early mid 30s, whatever the case may be? Why would he want to, you know, have to share that woman's time, dates that may get canceled because nobody can watch the baby, trips they cannot take because the baby may have to go to school or kindergarten? It's not fair towards the man. Men could have so much less stress with women who are young and who don't have any children. That is why so many women are out there who feel as though that they are somewhat high value, but at the end of the day, they're really not. And I'm not talking about them having a low value as far as a human being. I am not saying that. I'm talking about the sexual marketplace value compared to a woman who is young, whose womb has not been used yet. A woman with a child, or even more, has a lower value. And that is the case because that child is not going to be an asset to that man's life, even though that man is going to also have to provide for that child, including the woman. Because we need to remember, wanting to be with a high value man, you have to be an asset to his life. You even got to be an asset to an average man. I know I'm an asset for sure to my husband's life, and I'm not saying that because I think I'm special, but when that man needs help, I'm there every day, no matter what time of the day. Being an asset to a man's life in his career's career and whatever he has going on means not bringing something that takes away from his energy, his time, his financial resource, which actually the case is when a woman brings children into a relationship. So women really need to be a little bit more realistic with their own sexual marketplace value when they are out on the dating market, including children. It's not going to be easy. But like I said, I am not over here judging anybody. I'm just here trying to speak realistically about a topic and a situation, which again on social media is being put out to the point like it's the man's fault. Like that woman said in her comment, "This is beautiful. If you would act right, that's what you could have." How is a man supposed to act right? Why would a man have to act right taking care of another man's baby in the first? Because entering a relationship with a man is kind of like a job interview. Especially when he's high value, when he got things going on for himself, and you are able to actually be part of that.
You know, guys, it's so intriguing. This woman literally put up a clip, you know, saying that this is beautiful. This single mother brought her child, her baby, a date, and this is what you could have, what men could have, what black men could have if they act right. You could have a single mother that has to bring her child to a date. Like, this is how low they think of men in Western society. This is what they think of us. They've elevated themselves to this. Like, if a man tried some nonsense like this, women would be furious. But now they're literally struggling out here. Homelessness, hunger is on the horizon. You think she would have brought that kid if she didn't have to bring that kid? She didn't have anyone to watch that kid. She had no one to watch that kid. She needs help. Because food stamps ain't cutting it. Child support ain't cutting it. Because this man ain't making no money that she had that she had the child with. So child support ain't cutting it. You know, benefits just aren't cutting it. All right. And she needs to live. She needs to live. So she's going to do whatever she has to do. And she's going to bring that child. And, you know, that man is going to get to know that child because he's going to be taking care of that child. He's going to be responsible for that child and her. And let me tell you y'all something about these women. A lot of men don't understand that. It's not going to be easy to be with her. And when I say be with her, don't think that she's just going to give it up like that. A lot of dudes think that, oh, she's desperate. No, that's going to be the hardest. That will often be the hardest that a man has to go when dealing with a single mother, because that's her only asset. That's her only chip that's her only chip. So she will hold on to it tight. She will drain that man of his resources, of his time for months. She will keep that man dangling for 9 months. And he won't even get as much as a kiss on the cheek until he is in a relationship with her. They're in a committed relationship. Maybe even a ring is on the finger. And some of these women will literally come with this new bullcrap talking about she's a born again. So she can't have those types of relationships until she's married. And God has said that God says that it's okay. Nah, y'all, this is, we really living in the end of days right now. We're really living in the end of days.
And when on your resume it says that you have a child or two, you have not been cuffed by a man, not married for obvious reason, what does that man that you are currently dating think about you? That you're obviously for some reason are not wife material. Now, I'm not blaming everything on the men. Men aren't on the woman. Men aren't perfect either. I'm not sitting here blaming everything on a woman. I'm not doing that. But that's one of the main reasons why I'm like, you as a woman can't be out there trying to do whatever the man is doing. You can't be out there like, oh, I'm just going to live my life. You only live once. I'm going to party, get drunk, and I'm going to have a high body count. And women are actually proud of that. Women are actually proud of having a high body count, which got me thinking like, okay, even if you do have a high body count, your goal should be trying to hide. Your goal should not be, you know, trying to spread it into the world like it's an accomplishment. And a man is going to be able to tell whether if you have a high body count or not in any way. So yes, just to sum it up, I'm here to tell you, ladies, you cannot be out there spreading your legs to anyone because you may end up pregnant and alone, and then it's going to be really hard for you to find someone to deal. Now, there's always an exception to the rule. I already know this, but the most of the time is not going to work. I know people in my environment, and I'm also not talking about only melanated women, please. I have people in my family who I told this to. I keep it real with anybody. I give everybody the same energy, the same mess, and most of the time women don't like. Well, anyway, thank you so much for being here. Let me know what you think about this video and my thoughts. I would like to know your thoughts. Give it a like, give it a dislike, whatever you feel like. I'm always open for critique. Let me know in the comment section, and have a blessed day, and I'm looking forward for the next video.
So, I mean, guys, she brings up so many valid points. A lot of these women don't understand that the moment they have a child, you know, their SMV decreases, you know, their marketplace value decreases because it's based on their looks, their fertility. And also, men don't want to have to take authority for another child. When you look at the animal kingdom, when you look at lions, because there's no paternity there, because paternity is so difficult. If a female lion, a lioness comes to a male lion with children, he will do one of two things. Either he will accept those children as his own, or he will delete those children. This is how crazy it is in the animal kingdom. He will delete them. He will delete. And yet here we are being told that, oh, you could have this. This is so beautiful. You could have this. You could have a single mother bringing her little baby on a first date with a child over her shoulder, fast asleep. You could have this if you know how to act right. And then you wonder why these men are funneling themselves out of Western society. You know, I was talking to MK Fitness, and MK Fitness always says that, you know, we need the Sims, because with the Sims doing their thing and simping, the passport kings can shuffle out of the country, you know. But don't, but keep in mind, the women are noticing it. The women are noticing. They're watching the men leave. And there's a lot of Sims leaving too. There are a lot of Sims leaving and going over to the Philippines. The Philippines is rife with Sims right now. All those dudes losing all their money to bar girls because they thought some bar girl was a wife, and they couldn't tell that this girl, you know, you can tell. It's literally like what Soraya said. Any man that has experience with a woman, they can tell just based on the things that she said, that she says. Once you start, you know, once you start looking for the truth in her lies rather than the lies in her truth, and you assume that everything she says is a lie, and then you look for the truth in that, then you can basically begin discerning the lies from the truth when it comes to women, because women are programmed, predispositioned to lie, and they don't view it as lying. They the way that they work using girl math, girl logic, they don't even see it as lying. They don't see it as lying, and they have very selective memories as well. Very, very selective memories. They forget every bad thing they've ever done in their lives very quickly, and that's if they even identify them as doing bad. Men have to wake up. They have to wake up and realize that this is how these women are, and they just, and that's why they need to become passport kings and leave and walk away from this. You know, don't mess around. Look how, guys, this woman, this young Black woman, she was struggling. She didn't have anyone to watch those kids. If she could have her mother watch those kids, watch her kids, she would have had her mother watch her kid, watch that kid. She didn't have anyone. All right. She is fending off hunger and homelessness, and she brought this poor little baby to that date because she's trying to find a man to provide for her and him. What do you guys think regarding this? I want to know your thoughts in the comments, so we'll talk about it there. Like the video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe, and if you like the video, share the video. And just remember that all roads lead to MWA, men walking away, and cheers.